these from our bookshelf. So, yeah. The first one I have is Harry and the Hendersons. It's a bit of a glare there. It doesn't make amazing sounds, I think, because it sounds like maybe loose in the case, even though it hasn't even been taken out of the plastic yet. Here, let me turn off the TV. Christmas Story. And you have John Lithgow. And of course it's about finding a Bigfoot. So that's always good. And this sounds really funny, but this movie always reminds us kids of my dad. Because he always had kind of long hair and a beard. We've never seen him without a beard. So we used to joke that his face kind of looked like Harry. When I was younger, I was really big into pictures of unexplained phenomena like Bigfoot and the Loch Ness Monster and UFOs and ghosts. I'm a skeptic. Like, I love this stuff, but I'm not religious. I'm not an atheist either. I guess the closest I would be to anything would be agnostic, which means that I don't fully believe it's true without seeing it for myself, but I also don't deny that I can't prove it's not true. Basically, I'm open-minded. I was 7 years old. I didn't realize until like 6 years ago that this took place in Seattle. I actually haven't seen this one yet. Paranormal activity we're up to at this point, as far as how many have been released. This one kind of sounds like it's loose too. You know, I got a lot of these at Walmart, so they were pretty cheap. You know, some movies you really want on Blu-ray, but some movies you just want to own. So I don't know which paranormal activity we are up to in the real world yet. There might have been three more that came out after this one, or this might have been the last one that was out, I don't know. But like the first two, you know, there was so much just boring, realistic dialogue going on, and then just a couple of small things would happen, and then it got creepier and creepier, and that to me made it seem more realistic. You know, all the boring dialogue, it was almost like you were watching a reality show. Instead of a movie. Although, to be honest, I can't stand, as much as I love a good ghost story and reading about people's supposed ghost experiences, I cannot stand like ghost hunters and tabs and stuff like that. I liked them at first. All the annoying reality show stuff, like the shaking of the camera and the, oh my god, did you hear that when, you know, there's no way we heard it, or did you see that, just so annoying. This one's a nice one. Cover too, it's got texture on it. This is the Haunted Anthology. I guess it's kind of hard to see. The camera up the other way, you could see it better, but it has the Blair Witch Project, the Others, let's see, The Last Exorcism, that one. Insidious. I've never seen that. I'm guessing that's that one. And 1408, which would be this one right here. So, I don't think I've seen The Last Exorcism. Seen Insidious, but I've seen all the other ones. The Others really creeped me out. You know what part creeped me out the most? Was when the, was when you realized that the, well, actually, no. I think it was before you realized everyone was dead, but when the groundskeepers. When the groundskeepers were walking slowly up the yard and like the fog creeped me out. I don't know, it's been a really long time since I watched it. I don't think I was able to sit through it more than once. 1408, I really, really liked. That one was creepy too. Song would come on the radio really loud at the certain point when Mukbangs just moved to Erie, Indiana. And he starts noticing things that no one else but his new friend Simon seems to notice. Really weird paranormal type stuff that happens in the town. So each episode basically chronicles Simon go through. And most of you will recognize him, Omri Katz from Hocus Pocus. Special. Yeah. It's got Nightmare on Elm Street 2, Nightmare on Elm Street 3, Nightmare on Elm Street 4. Oh, and the first Nightmare on Elm Street. Scared me, but the first one, like when he's walking down the alley and his arms get really long, or when Tina is walking down the hall in Nancy's dream and like her guts spill out, that was kind of scary. Shows back up in this one, and her dad shows back up in this one, and you learn a little bit more about how Freddy came to be in this one, I think. is in the game and that episode. This is the Leprechaun complete collection up until 2014. I think that was probably the last Leprechaun that Warwick Davis played the Leprechaun. If you're not familiar with Warwick Davis, he was the dwarf actor that played Willow, and he's also been in a lot of the Star Wars movies. He's been an Ewok. I can't remember what else, but he's found his way in a lot of those movies, and I wish we would see him in more stuff. I know that they've either remade this or they're going to remake it with a new Leprechaun. I have not seen are Blame It on the Night, Little Nikita, Fast Forward, Immediate Family, and Fresh Horses. Now, what I have seen many, 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 many times is The Legend of Billie Jean. Slater, who played Supergirl in the Supergirl movie, stars in this movie. And it used to play on TV, I think on like TBS, constantly in the early 90s. Christian Slater is also in this movie, but they are not related in real life. Even though they played siblings in this movie, and both of their last names are Slater. Yeardley Smith is also in this movie. The woman who's the voice of Lisa Simpson. Another one that I have not seen yet. Open Water 3, Cage Dive. It sounds absolutely horrible, but I'm going to watch it because I really liked the first Open Water, even though it made me kind of seasick. I think just because it was like one of those worst nightmare type movies. Now the second Open Water, like, was really psychologically messed up. It, like, really tugged at my heart and stressed me out. Because in the second movie, it's not even sharks. It's this group of people that were friends somebody yells at the guy for throwing her in and being a jerk. They suddenly realize nobody let down the ladder on the boat, and there was no way to climb back onto the boat. So the entire movie is about how long they can last in the water psychologically before they can figure out how to get back on the boat. And at certain points, the baby starts to cry, and it's just awful. This is one of my favorites. Now, Troll was a movie that came out in, let's see, 1986, and it was about, if you guys have seen The NeverEnding Story, which I'm sure most of you have, the boy who played Atreyu, the actor Noah Hathaway, was the main character in this movie. Oddly enough, his father was named Harry Potter, and his name was Harry Potter Jr. And they moved into this apartment building. It was Harry Potter Jr., his father, his mom, and his younger sister. His younger sister started acting really weird after, you know, a few days of living there. And then you find out that she's been possessed by a troll. And this was actually, I really like this movie. It's kind of a cult classic. Dreyfus was in this movie, and Sonny Bono was in this movie. It's so random. I believe that one of the actors from Willow played a dwarf in this movie. Speaks to him, and he's the only one that can see him and hear him. And, what they've done is they've kind of, for this road trip, the family has swapped houses with another family. So these people that live on a farm are going to stay at their house, and they're staying on the farm. And like the minute they get there, grandfather warns the boy that all the food there is poison, and the people, there's something wrong with the people, they're out to get them. And the boy tries Betty, stop it. The cats are so bad at night. Anything. is Annabelle. Now, I actually have not seen this one. I do plan on watching it. I have seen the other movies, like The Conjuring 2. And I am familiar. When did I stop whispering? Damn, I don't know. Okay, let's get back to it. I have seen the Conjuring movies. And I am, like, I do know about Ed and Lorraine Warren. Because the first time I heard their name was the was researching that, and when I would read ghost storybooks, and I know that the actual Annabelle doll is actually a giant Raggedy Ann doll. Looks nothing like this. So I don't know what's creepier, a creepy looking doll that does creepy things, or a mm